the second day of Christmas. We try to burn off this flubber.
Good morning, y'all. Day two, 12 days of Christmas. About to get it in the gym. I missed yesterday, which, you know, I try not to miss Mondays, but oh well. So we're here. Y'all know this is just a little sweat cream on my face. And let's go.
Back, lift our legs up, turn it out to this right side. To create more tension, pull a little tighter. Hold it. Breathe and let's switch to the left side. If it makes it easier, turn and look to the side that you're turning out to with your head. The body follows the eyes. Follows the head, let's turn back, rotate back to the right side here. Choke up a little bit more if you can. Pull back a little bit harder. Try to get those hands down to the floor. Try to get those hands back, towards your back, towards the back of the sauna. Switch back to the left side now. We're almost here at the end. Home stretch, that finish line is here in sight. Right back to the right side. Now I want you to go at your own best pace throughout this hot band session. But right now I want you to push your own best pace. Create more resistance. You know, the only way we can overcome obstacles is to face them head on. Switch right back to the other side. Embrace what challenges you, because if it doesn't challenge you, it can never change you. And you're the only one that can level up that challenge and elevate. Now transition back to the right side. We haven't given up on you. Ooh, we're right here, baby. Final reps coming. Breathe.
I'm back.
Keep that smile nice and wide.
Y'all, have a meeting with my financial advisor this morning and it was not on my calendar. Why? I don't know. Because I literally live by my calendar. She just texted me. She's like, are we still meeting today? I hate like being delayed for getting appointments, you know, like I don't know. And it's like I didn't even get like a reminder. Like what? Okay, y'all, I'm trying to find the link. November 23rd. Yeah, definitely a meeting today. All right, y'all, let me hop on this. All right, we got outfit of the day. Green pants, green top, blazer. Those are all from Zara. This belt might be from Zara also. These shoes are not Zara. I just can't remember where I got these from. So we are headed to work. Well, really, I have a class that I'm going to go to. Y'all, let me tell you, in real estate, it's always classes. It's always something to learn. So right now, right now, I am headed to, I recently switched brokerages. And if you follow my real estate vlogs, you haven't seen that yet because I haven't posted the November vlog or the October, I don't think. So I recently switched brokerages. So my new brokerage offers just like what a lot of other big brokerages would like offer, like trainings, classes, you know, all of that stuff. I don't know if they're doing lunch. Let me take this blazer off. So yeah, so right now I'm headed to a title company. They are, I don't know if they're sponsoring lunch. It's a lunch and learn or not. But anyways, going to a title company. They're doing a class called Divorce, Probate, and Rebate or something like that. But basically, it's just a class that will teach realtors and other real estate professionals, really just realtors, of how you handle those type of situations or things that can come up during the transaction when the title company is doing their title commitments and things like that, and you're in situations like that. Because clearly a lot of people sell houses when they're getting divorced, right? We're crooked, y'all. Or like when people pass away, probate, all of that. So anyways, y'all know I tend to ramble. I'm going to that class right now to just learn more about that and just to be privy to this information when and if I ever do run into a situation like that. I haven't had the pleasure of working with any divorced couples or any like probate sales or anything of that nature. So yeah, they're currently fixing the ghetto gate at this apartment. Y'all, like these gates, I don't know how they're always breaking. It's like they get off track or somebody hits them or just whatever. But, all right, y'all, I'm running my mouth. Gotta go, bye. The day is still going. Lunch was good. Well, really, first of all, back to the class that I went to. Class was informative. Learned a good amount of stuff. Well, really, a light learn. But you know, it was cute. Learned more about what that title company offers as far as their services and just technology and stuff like that that can make transactions go smoother, keep you up to date better, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then, okay, sis, just pull on out so I can't get in. And then you let the man take the spot that I was trying to go to. Anyway, so then I went to lunch with two of the girls from the brokerage. One I already knew. We were at a previous brokerage together. The other one we met last week, sweet girls. Just had, you know, a nice little personal but business lunch talk. And yeah, now I have some time to waste because it's 2:30. I have showings at 5:15, but I do need to go return this something to Zara. Still need to pick up two Christmas gifts. So yeah, and like I'm at the mall circling because I guess, you know, the mall is busy or whatever. So yeah, that's where we're at with it. And I need to tinkle really badly. So maybe I'll just stalk somebody to their car until I find a parking spot. Do y'all do that? You just stalk people in the parking lot? Like, and I'm not even being lazy. Like, parking lot just full. There's nowhere to park. Nowhere to park. Okay, y'all. I'm letting time pass here a little bit. Came into Home Goods. I like to get these candles. Ooh. They're the Ray Dunn candles. They just say home on the front. The white one is the same. It says home. I like to stock up on those because I put those in my closing gift baskets. And every time I'm looking for them, I can never find them. So whenever I find them, I like to grab all of them. So that's what those are for. And then here's just some like decorative ribbon. So y'all know I need to do my clients' gifts and I needed ribbon, so that will be for that. And then my little brother is into stones and all of that stuff, so I'm gonna get these for him for Christmas because I saw he sent my other sister his Christmas list. He didn't send it to me, but he had like some of these on there, so you know, I'm just gonna grab those for him. Although I'm supposed to be buying him a mirror, sending me his Christmas list because I owe him a mirror. Andre bought a house this summer in May, and I promised him for his housewarming gift that I would buy him a nice decorative mirror. Sister still has not done that. So
I'm sure he's assuming he's gonna be getting that for Christmas. Saying I need to find one. I still haven't bought one. And now I'm just like, I don't need to be excessive with it, y'all. These are $9.99. I feel like they're usually $6.99. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 should do me a good to like the, we'll see, I don't know. But I'm gonna stop at 5 because I'll take all these gifts. So I'm over here looking at the mirrors, and Andre Edwards wants something rustic. This is the reason why he hasn't gotten a mirror yet, because I was going to buy him a nice sleek IKEA mirror that forgot what it's called, but they're really popular mirror because it's really nice size and sleek and, you know, all that. He told me, I don't like that. He wants something rustic. I don't know when my brother became so bougie. Around the time he bought a house, he turned into a bougie man. He get that from his daddy, y'all. So I don't really see anything over here in Home Goods that is rustic, full body. And you know, he's a big boy, so I want a big mirror. I don't want him to have to step too far back. You know, he need to be able to fit. So I don't know. Any ideas of where I can find a nice rustic mirror that is less than $200? Let me know. About like 65 inches long, maybe 20 to 30 inches wide. Really big mirror. 65 plus. If you can do 70, that's good. And then for mom, I just realized I ordered Pandora chains because y'all know she bought me the Pandora bracelet. And so now, of course, we're all obsessed with getting, not chains, charms. So I ordered her a charm, and I just realized, you know, I've been ordering a lot of stuff lately. Holiday season. The charm that I ordered her was not in the delivery package. So I need to call them and have them refund me my $35. So either I can go somewhere and buy that same charm, or find... I shouldn't be talking about this because she's gonna see this before Christmas if she watched the vlog. Never mind, y'all. Amazon has failed me, y'all. My package is delayed a day or two. The little boxes that I ordered because I was wanting to have them shipped out by tomorrow. Delayed. And this pimple is annoying. Anyways, we are in Houston traffic, 4:30. Have those showings at 5:15. Looks like there's a few slowdowns. Estimated time of arrival 5:24. I've already texted my clients to let them know, because my thing is, what I hate the most, you know, being late, people usually give you, you know, a little grace, a little window, 10 minutes or so, which is fine. But what I hate about being late is, like, if you know you're gonna be late, just let me know as soon as you figure out you're gonna be late, I guess, you know. So it's 4:30. I'm already texting them, letting them know that I'm gonna be running late, so they won't at least be rushing to get there on time. And then I show up late and I text them like 10 minutes before we're supposed to be there, or a minute before I'm supposed to be there, and they're like, oh, well, you could at least tell me, you know. Like, I personally hate when people do that. Like, if you're gonna be late, I'm understanding of the lateness, go ahead, be late, but let me know in advance that you're going to be late, so I'm not rushing to get to you at a certain time and you ain't even showing up at the agreed time. Yeah, y'all know what I mean? Anyways, let me get off the thing. I gotta drive. Okay, got my phone in the little holder thing, so now I can talk to y'all. So I went on to Pandora's website, and I love when stores have just like the live chats, so you don't actually have to call and be on hold. Like, you can just chat. So anyways, I chatted. I told them my mom's charm was not delivered. So hopefully it'll be here before Christmas. They said 5 to 7 business days. Yeah, fingers crossed. If she watches this, mommy, you're getting a charm for Christmas. And yeah, I had something else to tell y'all too. I don't recall. Yeah, see, 13 minutes slowdown. And for those of y'all who are like, well, Alexia, you should have left earlier, you shouldn't have went to the store or whatever,
After I left lunch, I was gonna head directly to the house, but I would have been sitting there for an hour. I knew I needed to find some other little Christmas gifts and things. So I said, okay, well, let me just go to this Home Goods that's right here. It takes me about 45 minutes to get from where I was to over there. I was leaving in enough time for me to get there in 45 minutes. I can't control a 13-minute slowdown. Like, it's not my fault. So, traffic is traffic, though. You coming to Houston? Come on, baby. My name is Alexia Nikole. If you need a real estate agent, go ahead, send me a message, send me an email, my contact. It's all down there below. Ooh, I need to make sure it's all down there below. So, okay, yeah, yeah. And this braid out is giving me braid out life. I love it. It's 8 p.m. I'm just getting home. We got Chick-fil-A for dinner. I got a tinkle. And that is, it's a long day, y'all. I showed 3 properties. Just clients are trying to make a decision on, they're gonna rent, buy, lease a house, rent another apartment, just all over the place. But anyways, y'all, I hope you enjoyed day 2 of 12 Days of Christmas. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye.